In this lecture, we'll study next DFT property, that is circular convolution in time domain property, or we can call it as convolution property. This property states that when two n-point sequences are circularly convolved in the time domain, their n-point DFTs are multiplied in the frequency domain. In other words, circular convolution in time domain is equal to or equivalent to multiplication in frequency domain. That is, suppose x of n and y of n are discrete signals . Then according to this theorem, it states that if n point DFT of x of n is say x of k, and n point DFT of another sequence y of n is say y of k, convolution of these two sequences, that is circular convolution of x of n and y of n, its n point DFT is equal to product of their DFTs, that is x of k dot y of k. We know that the circular convolution between sequence x of n and y of n is given by summation say l is equal to 0 to n minus 1 x of l y of n minus l. So now according to the statement, we'll try to find DFT of this sequence, that is DFT of x of n circular convolved with y of n is equal to summation n is equal to 0 to n minus 1, the input, that is x of n y of n into w n power n k. We'll call it as equation 1, we'll call it as equation 2. So now equation 2 can be rewritten as, by substituting the value of x of n circular convolution with y of n, that is summation n is equal to 0 to n minus 1. So here we can see that this is nothing but equation number 1, that is another summation l is equal to 0 to n minus 1 x of l y of n minus l. Then this term, that is w n power n k. Now changing the order of summation, in above equation so that I can represent it as summation, I will write this order first, that is l is equal to 0 to n minus 1. I'll take this term, that is x of l, then I will write the remaining term, that is another summation n is equal to 0 to n minus 1, the remaining term is y of n minus l dot w n power n k. So now we know that by circular time shift property, this DFT of x of n minus m, it gives as w n power m k x of k. So now similarly, now we'll apply circular time shift property to this expression, that is by circular shift circular time shift property, this expression can be represented as summation n is equal to 0 to n minus 1 y of n minus l w n power n k is equal. Wn power l into k y of k, that is dft of y of n minus l is nothing but wn power lk y of k, which is same as this one. So therefore now I can represent this expression as, call it as equation 3. So therefore equation 3 can be rewritten as dft of x of n y of n is equal to summation l is equal to 0 to n minus 1 x of l wn power lk dot y of k. So this is nothing but, here we can see that this expression is dft expression, that is dft of x of l is nothing but x of k dot y of k. Therefore x of n circular convolution with y of n, its n point dft is equal to x of k dot y of k, that is circular convolution in time domain is equal to product of dfts in frequency domain. Thank you for watching.